Aloha! Welcome to day number 81 as we continue our series on Romans 8, 28. This is the third video in that series. Let's remind ourselves of the verse, Romans 8, 28. And we know that all things work together for good to them that love God, to them who are the called according to his purpose. Let's open in a word of prayer. Dear Heavenly Father, we come to you now. Thank you so much for who you are. Thank you for YouTube. Thank you for technology that we can go to that. Thank you for your word. And in both of these areas, we can grow in our relationship with you. And I pray that we would do that, both the audience and myself. I pray that you'd speak through me this hour, that hearts would be tender, minds would be focused, remove the devil and his distractions. And once this is over, help us to spend time in your word, your will, your way, praising your name, bringing forth prayer requests, and just again, growing in our relationship with you. Lord, we love you. Thank you for all that you do. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. All right, here we go. Continuing on in our journey of Romans 8:28. How is this story going to work together for good to them that love God? Today we're going to be talking about Jim Elliot, Pete Fleming, Ed McCauley, Roger Yudurian, and Nate Saint. We're going to be talking about those five missionary men. The way that I was introduced to them was actually through my youth pastor at the time. You guys know who he is. He's been on this channel before, Brother Mike Free. And when I was a teenager, I was going into eighth grade. One of the requirements in order to go on missions trips for our church, or specifically for our youth group, is we had to do a book report. And this particular summer's book was about these five men called Men of Faith, Jim Elliot. And had to read the book, do a book report. And this was the first book I'd ever read about a missionary. First time I even heard about a missionary. And so this was all brand new to me, and their story had a very profound and major impact on my life. And so I hope that it'll do the same for you. If you ever want the book, go to Amazon, eBay, just look up Jim Elliot, Men of Faith. It's a really awesome book. And there's more books than that. But let's just jump into it here. So these five guys in the 1950s, they had a desire to share the gospel, specifically in a place called Ecuador. And even more specifically, they wanted to share the gospel with a tribe called the Auca Indians, A-U-C-A. And Auca actually means savage. And so they had this desire, like, look, these guys have probably never heard the gospel. They've never heard of God. They never heard of Jesus Christ. We have got to get the gospel to these people. But they knew the dangers. That's the thing. They knew, hey, listen, these guys, they've been in the papers before for killing oil company workers, you know, and the Auca Indians, their mindset was anyone that was foreign or that wasn't a part of their tribe, they were out to harm them, they were out to kill them, so better for me to kill them first than for them to kill me. And so these missionaries knew that, and so they're like, all right, we gotta try to make ourselves more friendly before we actually meet them face to face. And so Nate Saint had a great idea. He was actually a pilot in World War II, and they had a small yellow plane, and they said, hey, why don't we fly over the tribe and we'll lower a basket down with some goods, some supplies, things like that. And Jim Elliot, I believe he had a megaphone, and they would shout out. They knew a little bit of the language, just a little bit. They would shout out like, welcome, friends, you know, nice things like that, but they didn't know enough to share the gospel. But so that's what they did. They would fly their plane over, lower the basket down, and basically wait until the Auca Indians would come out. And a few of them would start to come out and see what's in the basket, take the supplies. And so they got into this routine of doing that. And then one day, the Auca Indians put a gift in there for the men. And so they were like, oh, praise the Lord, you know, making headway. They thought, you know, hey, we're showing them that we're friendly. We're not here to do them any harm. And so they got the idea, all right, let's take the risk and land the plane this time. So that's what they did. They landed the plane on the beach, and one Auca man and two Auca women came out. And obviously there wasn't much conversation going on, but they were trying to, you know, just let them know, hey, we're friendly, we're not here to hurt you, just trying to establish that relationship. And then through some hand signals and movements, the Auca man wanted to actually go up in the plane. And he kept pointing to the sky and pointing to the plane. And so Nate Saint said, all right, let's do it. And so he got the Auca man in, and they flew the plane over the tribe. And, you know, he was shouting out things in his own language, probably something like, hey, look at me, I'm above you guys, you know, something like that. But landed the plane safely, everybody was friendly, and everybody left. Okay, so Nate Saint and the rest of the men flew back, and they were able to communicate to their families, to their wives. Their wives were in Ecuador as well, but they were far enough away from the Alca Indians to not really be in danger. And so they would communicate through radio and things like that, and letting them know their praises and the meetings that they had had and how awesome it was. And so, you know, they wanted to try again. Now, one thing that they had with them, because they knew of the danger, was a handgun. But all of the men agreed and prayed about it that they would not use the handgun on the Alca Indians. And what I mean by that, if they were going to be attacked, they would just shoot it in the air and hope that the sound would scare them away to not attack them. But they decided, we would rather die than kill one of them and send them to hell. Because all five men knew they had accepted Christ. They knew if they died, they were going to go to heaven. But they didn't want to take another man's life that would be destined for hell. Because the whole point in them being there was though these men and women would come to Christ. And so they knew that danger, but they were going to take that risk anyway. And so January 8th, 1956, they landed the plane and they were hoping for some more interaction, friendly interaction. And several Alca men showed up, but these were warriors and they had their spears and they were not friendly. And unfortunately, they came out, charged the five missionaries, threw the spears, and killed all five men. And it was a very sad day, that specific day. Jim Elliott's wife, Elizabeth Elliott, you know, kept waiting to hear, and the other men's wives kept waiting to hear on the radio, but nothing ever came. And so they knew something went wrong. They're very sad. And another guy who had a plane flew his plane over, and he saw the yellow plane. It kind of been damaged and ripped apart. And then eventually they found the bodies of the five men. And these five guys, their story was put in into a magazine, a Lifetime magazine. And it went nationwide about these five men dying for Jesus Christ. And you say, wait a second. With Ron Hamilton, you know, he lost his eye. With this other missionary guy, he lost his leg. But they got to live and all things work together for good. They loved God. And it worked together for good for them. How is it possible these five men get brutally murdered? How does that work together for good for God? They showed love to God and they lost their lives. How does that work? Well, their story did not stop January 8th, 1956. Here we are in 2020 and we're still talking about him. And their testimony and their strive to share the gospel still lives on and has inspired multiple generations of missionaries. It's led multiple people to the Lord. And the amazing thing is Jim Elliott's wife, Elizabeth Elliott, took their daughter, Valerie, back there a couple of years later. And they went with Nate Saint's sister, Rachel, and they actually lived amongst the Alca Indians. They eventually learned the language. The Alca Indians eventually started to be able to speak English, and they accepted Christ. Even the men that killed the missionaries accepted Christ. Talk about forgiveness. The wife of the man who was murdered potentially led her murderer, her husband's murderer, to the Lord. Wow. And that's why they were there. Okay. Even though they died, the gospel still got to them. Okay, and the gospel from these men's testimony didn't just begin and end with the Alca Indians. It is nationwide. So many more people came to know the Lord as their personal Savior as a result of these men's deaths rather than them living long lives. So it did work together for good because they loved God. So, and the interesting thing too, Stephen Saint, who is Nate Saint's son, he's a grown man now, he still lives and ministers to the Alca Indians even to this day. So Romans 8:28, and we know that all things work together for good to them that love God, to them who are the called according to his purpose. Even through a loss of a loved one, we still need to show love to God, because you never know whose life might be saved as a result. All right, got a couple questions for you here. Some are from Genesis chapter 40. That's the book and chapter you need to read today. First question here is from the video. Who was the pilot of the missionary team? Number two, this one's from the Bible, Genesis 40. Who was thrown into prison with Joseph? There were two people. You won't have their names, but it does tell their jobs. Who was thrown into prison with them? Number three, this one's from the Bible. Of the three men, who gets out of jail after 3 days? Number four, of the three men, who died? Number five, this is from the video. What is Jim Elliot's wife's name? And number six, who still lives with the Aka tribe today, and who was he related to on the missionary team? And number seven, how did I find out about Jim Elliot? We love you, and aloha.